Here today to unlock a new beginning with the trailer launch of Amazon Prime Video's first Tamil original movie, Puttam Pudhu Kale.
Miracle do happens.
It's 12 o'clock, ma. Happy birthday.
I know it's hard, but you have to get through this.
What's up? Na love use panna theriyudhu pesukku.
Appo style enna nu solli kudu.
Adha 21 naal iruke. Enna solli thara.
Nammana adhu sey nadakkum.
Love, I love it.
Lockdown is over, Tata. Veliya, micha irukkira ulagatha poi paakalama?
I totally understand it, and we're trying to keep her as mature or as responsible a face as we must. But Kali, of course, you know, you're a star in your own right. You know, you've been acting since the tender age of 6 and 7. And over the years, we've seen you experiment with different genres and versatile characters. Tell me, is there some sort of a guide where you say, this is the sort of character that I'd like to play? How do you choose that I want to give life to this character?
If I'm being very honest, like, I don't think we can choose, because I just do what comes my way. Because there's so many actors and there's so many, you know, very little characters to be played. I think it's already taken. So whatever comes my way, I just do it. And thankfully, I just got a very good, mentor like Sudha ma'am, who gave me this opportunity to work with her. So I'm just happy.
There's a lot riding on you, and there's a lot of pressure because you've got to be in form. Your throat can't be bad. You can't have a fever. You've got to look a certain way. You know, and when you think of a pandemic, it's obvious that you have to put yourself first. But when the shot starts, you know, do you forget everything and just, you know, focus on that shot itself? I want to know the inner workings of how does an actor deal with a pandemic which is so prevalent all over?
When we shot this movie, we already had gone through 4 months of lockdown. So I was just waiting to go back to work. I didn't care about the pandemic or anything. I just wanted to work. So maybe I was just happy to be there in the set. But I spent 4 months at home seeing my father's face. And then I go back to work expecting to see someone else. And then I see his face. So that is not fun.
Correct. Ma'am, thank you so much for joining me. From me, from my mother, from my family, just want to say big fan. Let me start with that.
Thank you so much, Nandri.
Yes, thank you. Ma'am, I want to take you back to the idea of, you know, bringing a family together on screen. Did you have the cast in mind while thinking of your story?
First, I have to tell you, I came in last. I think these four people were already on board. And okay. I think someone came last to me. And then when they wanted me to do a film, and I had two kinds of stories. And one story was similar to what Karthik Subbaraj was doing. I heard that there were some similarities. So then I thought, what about a short story that I'd written about 10 years ago about two daughters and a son coming back home for their parents' 50th anniversary, and the confrontations and the conflicts that they have, because the two daughters have lived abroad all the time. And when they come, they feel even more stressed because they're not there for the parents. You know, that was my idea of a short story many years ago, but I hadn't completed the short story. Mm-hmm. Thanks to Amazon, I completed the story and I changed the son to a daughter to accommodate Shruti. So I wanted to have all the Hasans. I mean, I still consider myself a Hasan, you know, Maniratnam, yes, okay. But unfortunately, a week before the shoot, my father met with an accident, and I mean, he fell down and broke his collarbone. So Kathadi Ramamurthy came in. Otherwise, it would have been all Hasan cast. So it has me, Suhasini Hasan, Maniratnam, and then Anu Hasan, Shruti Hasan, and Komalam Charu Hasan, my mother, who's coming into films after seeing Kamal and myself and, Mani and my father and Anu Hasan, Shruti Hasan. And, you know, she's the newcomer into film industry. So it was a casting coup of sorts. But, you know, it was not difficult, because we had these pictures of on the wall for the you know, for the set. It was so easy, I could pull it out from the album and, you know, do it. I didn't have to, you know, beg my artist, please give me a family photo, give me a childhood photo of yours. I could do that. There were advantages. There were many disadvantages, I guess. I mean, it was fun working with my family, except everybody thought I was, you know, like being very strict with my mother.
The question is, what message would you like to drive home to the viewers during the pandemic, or maybe through your film?
Hello to Jyoti Venkatesh. It's been a long time, Jyoti, since I've seen you. And nice to have a question from you. What do I want to tell family? I think it's time that we value the things that we have and not try for something that we don't have. Especially the SPB's death has kind of shaken all of us. And it's time we started recognizing the love and talent that is around us. I think my film is something like that. A family is concentrating on one person who's very special to all of them. And some people in the family have actually had some conflicts and confrontation with that particular relative, and they've kept away from that person. But the pandemic brings all of them together. See, we all grew up in big joint families. I mean, today's children are not, they don't have the luxury of growing up in a large joint family. Somewhere, I think the pandemic kind of put in that joint family, you know, concept again. I think we should spend a lot of time with people we love and say sorry to them and say, I love you, because it might be too late. If you don't say, I love you, and if you don't say, I'm sorry, and if you don't say, like, I really admire you, it might be too late. I think my film is also saying the same thing.
I'm going to take this to Gautam Vasudev Menon. Interesting. What was the liberty that you took as a filmmaker while you work, you know, in an anthology format? I'm not so sure what the question means, but I'd like to think you can make a little bit of sense of it. Is there a liberty as a filmmaker that you've taken while making this short?
Well, I think these ideas and scripts will not get to be in a feature film in the first place. Mm-hmm. So that's correct. Liberation by itself, you know, and your whole short division and everything. Mm-hmm. You're actually filming for the content and not worrying about the magic or the mood of the theater, and will the audience be affected 10 minutes into the screenplay? You know, should a particular lengthy shot be there? You're not thinking of all that. So I think that's what the question is trying to find out, is what I'm thinking. I think it's very liberating in that sense itself, from the concept to the length, to the way you film itself, you know. And like I said, how can you convince a producer about a story between a grandfather and a granddaughter? It's done 25 years ago, but it's not going to be so easy now. They're going to be asking you who's the hero and what the business is like and stuff like that. So I think that's what this means. Yeah.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.